I am Dr. V.K. Chauhan, homeopathic physician. I am sharing with you my revision of Ethusa-Sinapium. Ethusa-Sinapium was proved by Nening in 1828. It is a children's remedy. Its constitution is, somatic characteristics include best suitable for children during dentition, and psychic component has incapability to think, they are confused. Organ affinity is mind, central nervous system, gastrointestinal tract. Thermal sensitivity is heart subject. Lateral affinity is ambilateral. Miasmatic affinity is syphilitic miasm. Diathesis is for mental retardation, milk intolerance and summer diarrhea. Causation is hot summer weather, improperly fed babies. Characteristics of this remedy include complaints with prostration and sleepiness, expression of great anxiety and suffering, complete absence of thirst, intolerance of milk, vomits soon after, sleepy soon after vomiting, diarrhea and spasms, diarrhea, summer and dentition diarrhea, indigestion with regurgitation, herpetic eruption on nose, epileptic spasms, neck is weak, unable to support the head, cramps and convulsions. General aggravation is after eating or drinking milk, after vomiting, after stool, after spasms, summers, during dentition. Amelioration is by walking in open air. Posology, potency, best potency is lower dilutions, repetition, bears frequent repetition very well, duration of action, no definite information available. Clinical, as a constitutional specific remedy for mental retardation, here we find idiocy of children who are incapable of thinking, confused, brain trouble, say for example like cerebral palsy, children who cannot stand and are unable to hold up the head. Second condition where it is suitably indicated is infantile diarrhea. So summer diarrhea, dentition diarrhea with sleepiness, infantile cholera with vomiting, dehydration, prostration and sleepiness, expression of great anxiety and pain, pale hypocritic face and sunken eyes, stool contains yellow-green slime, absence of thirst is characteristic. Milk intolerance, best adapted to children who cannot bear milk. Indigestion of teething children, violent, sudden, vomiting of frothy milk, white substance or yellow fluid, followed by curdled milk and cheesy matter. Cannot bear milk in any form. It is vomited in large curds as soon as taken. Then weakness is caused by loss of fluid, which is followed by drowsiness. Indigestion. Indigestion with regurgitation of food an hour or so after eating, copious green vomiting, hungry soon after vomiting, gastric symptoms are accompanied with peculiar expression of great anxiety and pain. Epilepsy. Epileptic spasms with clenched thumbs, red face, eyes turned downwards, pupil fixed and dilated, foam at the mouth, jaws locked, pulse small, hard, quick. We have reviewed the Kent repertory for rubrics having first grade representation of Ethusa-Sinapium. Strangely, there is not a single rubric within the reason of mind. We get certain reasons like face, where we have four rubrics. Number one, face drawn. Number two, face eruption, herpes, nose. Number 3, face expression anxious. Number 4, face hypocritic. Second section is the stomach section, where we find 5 rubrics: stomach, indigestion, milk after. Second is stomach vomiting. Third, stomach vomiting milk after. Fourth, stomach vomiting milk. And fifth is stomach vomiting milk curdled. Rectum section has got 2 rubrics. Number 1, rectum cholera infantum, a very direct kind of a rubric. And rectum diarrhea children, again it is a very direct rubric, very important rubric. Generalities has only 1 rubric, which is generalities food milk aggravates. So entire drug represents 12 first grade symptoms in Kent repertory. Thank you very much for listening. Thanks.